Faraday's law, Faraday induction law. Faraday's law, Faraday's induction law. Faraday's induction law. What is the Faraday's induction law? Right now, flux linked with the coil. Flux linked with the coil. Flux linked with the coil changes. Right, there is a induced EMF. Right, there is a induced EMF. There is a potential drop. Because of the potential drop, there is a current. Because of the current, there is a deflection in the galvanometer. Deflection in the galvanometer. Now, right, we know that. Therefore, V is equals to 5 by A. Right? Flux linked with the coil changes. Flux is changing. Flux is changing means B is also changing. Therefore, that shows variable magnetic field. Variable magnetic field. Therefore, in any coil, by means of anything, by doing of anything, you want to create variable magnetic fields. Because of variable magnetic fields, what happens? The flux linked with the coil changes. As the flux linked with the coil changes, there is an induction of, that is induced EMF. Now, here in this case, how to change the flux linked with the coil? How to change the flux linked with the coil? Right? Therefore, maintaining relative motion between coil and magnet by sending variable current. By sending variable current. Right? Variable current means, suppose during the switch off. Variable current means, suppose during the switch on, current is increased from 0 to 10 amps, let us consider. During the switch off, that is, current is decreased from 10 amps to, that is, 0. Right? Now, here in this case, by maintaining the relative motion between the coil and magnet, the flux linked with the coil changes. Therefore, within the coil, there is an induced EMF. Because of the induced EMF, there is a current. Next one. By sending the, what to say, variable current, as the current passing through the coil is changed. As the current passing through the coil changes, means, suppose let us consider there is a coil. What is the current? I. Current carrying circular coil. Current carrying circular coil at the center, what is the magnetic field? What is the magnetic field? B is equals to mu naught N I by 2R. Suppose in the coil, if you change the current, magnetic field is changed. Therefore, as the magnetic field is changed, that is 5 by A, flux is also changed. Let us consider there is a coil. Through the coil, send variable current. Send variable current means during the switch on, there is a variable current. During the switch off, there is a variable current. As the variable current is there, as the variable current is there, magnetic field is also variable. As the magnetic field is variable, the flux linked with the coil changes. Therefore, in this case, there is an induced EMF. Now, what is the Faraday's law? Right, in any coil, by means of anything, that is change the magnetic flux, produce the variable magnetic field. Therefore, what is the Faraday's law? What is the Faraday's law means, as the flux linked with the coil changes, there is an induced EMF, right? That induced EMF is directly proportional to negative rate of change of magnetic flux. This is called, what to say, Faraday's law of induction. Now, what is flux? That is, phi is the flux. What is change in flux? D phi. What is the rate of change in flux? D phi by dt. Therefore, here, induced EMF is directly proportional to negative rate of change of magnetic flux linked with the coil. Therefore, E is equals to some constant 1, that equals to d phi by dt. If the coil has n turns, therefore, E is equals to, what to say, n into d phi by dt, right? Therefore, this is called Faraday's law of induction. This negative sign shows direction of EMF, shows the direction of EMF. Therefore, induced EMF is produced. This induced EMF can have magnitude and direction. Induced EMF magnitude can be calculated by Faraday's induction law. Direction of EMF can be calculated by, what do you say, Lenz law. This minus sign is by the Lenz law. Right? What is the Lenz law? Now already, right? Now E is equals to, what do you say, N into d by dt of phi. Phi is equals to BA, that is phi is equals to BA, E is equals to minus N, what to say, B is a constant, dA by dt. This is called, what to say, Newman law, right? This is also known as Newman law, E is equals to minus NB into dA by dt. Now, whatever the minus is produced by Lenz law. What is the Lenz law? Right, there, suppose there is a, what to say, coil, right? Here the coil is there, right? Because of certain cause there is a induced EMF, right? Therefore, the induced EMF is produced in such a way to oppose the cause is called Lenz law. Therefore, as the flux linked with the coil changes, there is an induced EMF. That induced EMF can have the both magnitude and direction. Magnitude of induced EMF can be determined by the Faraday's induction law, and direction can be determined by the Lenz law. What is the magnitude? Induced EMF is directly proportional to negative rate of change of magnetic flux linked with the coil. Therefore, E is equals to minus d phi by dt. As the coil has n turns, E is equals to minus into n into d phi by dt. As phi is equals to, that is, B into A, B is keeping out NB into dA by dt. Or area is changed. Sometimes area is kept constant. As sometimes area is kept constant, that is, this is called, what to say, dB by dT. Therefore, here E is equals to minus NA into dB by dT. Right, next one. This minus is according to the Lenz law. What is the Lenz law? Right, induced EMF is produced by a cause because of change in flux, because of increase of flux, because of decrease of flux. there is a induced EMF. The induced EMF is produced in a coil to oppose the cause. To oppose the cause means, suppose flux is increased, then induced EMF is produced in the direction of decrease of flux. Suppose the induced EMF is produced due to the decrease of magnetic flux. Now induced EMF is produced in such a way to increase the magnetic flux. Therefore, EMF is produced always in such a way that is to oppose the cause, that is called Lenz's law.